know, this being the first time he's on Matchroom on Sky Sports, for Matchroom Sky Sports, we want to showcase his skills and show him what he can do. So, you know, we don't want an easy test by any means, but we want a good, tough opponent that's going to, you know, let him show his skills and put him under a bit of pressure, and you can see what he's all about. So.
I was out hill running this morning, so this is my second session. This is probably the first time in 10 years I've been away from the gym, to be honest. I've not been away since I've started boxing, so I think around April time, I took the full April, I was just running and do a bit of circuit work and that. So then I think end of maybe mid-May or maybe end of May, I started going back to the gym. So
the rematch between you and McGregor will be huge. Where and when would you like that rematch to be?
Where it's going to be, you know, I mean, I'm not too bothered. At the moment, that's still my focus, you know, man, and I'll focus on the 17th of October. You know, I know people want to obviously see that fight again. You know, I mean, he's got a fight coming up, he's focused on that. I've got my fight coming up, I'm focused on that. So if you get the wins, then obviously we can talk there, you know what I mean? But wherever it is, you know what I mean, I would love that as well, rematch, you know.
I don't think there's any pressure. I think, you know, the pressure's probably on me, because everybody's saying, you know, a good percentage of people are saying to him, I didn't win the fight. So I'd be sitting at home with that British title belt going, maybe did him, maybe I didn't know. You got it in the judges' eyes, but the public's got a big saying things, a lot of pressure. So I know he's saying we're not saying anything, but no, we'll be waiting, and we'll happily, if he's at that weight, stays there, get the rematch. I think it goes without saying, you know, you need rivalries in boxing, and these two would, you know, they sold that Emirates no problem. They would make a massive event with the two fighting again. So hopefully Lee wins the European title, which would be fantastic for Scottish boxing, fantastic for Lee's. I can't guide us, no, you know, there's nothing like that at all. Just obviously we wanted the win, never got it. If it happens again, it'd be a tremendous fight for both of them. You know, absolutely great fight. And then, you know, if that's a good fight again, we do it a three time, we make a Scottish trilogy. Is that ever been done? I don't know, you know, it'd be a great thing.
Not many people coming off a loss or offered a contract with Matchroom. You must be delighted to be signed with Eddie Hearn now.
Yeah, I am, to be honest, because see, after that fight, I'm not with a big promoter, so I don't know where I was going in my career. So, you know, I was going to get back to small hall shows again. So I got to thank Eddie Hearn and Matchroom for coming in and signing me on, and I'm really grateful.
I did see your interview together. He thinks you're going to be a world champion one day. Would that be the ultimate dream for you?
Yeah, it is. You know, for me, I've always had the same thought in my head. I would just take a fight at a time. Since I've had my first amateur fight, I would just take a fight at a time and keep doing what you're doing, and things will just fall in place, you know what I mean? And you know, they have. This is, I'm here now, you know. Trainer there, Bobby McDermott, he's the one that got me into boxing. He introduced me to most of the people in boxing, so I would say him, but obviously he was well before my time, but in a way I really looked up to him. When I came to the gym, I didn't think it was going to be something I was going to do the rest of my life, and it did turn out to be a career. But I think every fighter's goal has always been a world champ, but I think as much as you want to do well in boxing, I want to be financially secure outside in boxing, so if I've done that, I'll be really, really happy, you know. I think it's discipline, a lot of patience, dedication, you know, and you can't let small things get to your head, you know. Maybe a defeat, you know, maybe fights getting called off, maybe. So you just need, I think, chip away, and your time will come, I think, eventually. I know there'll be a lot of them be watching on TV and Sky Sports, so I can't thank it enough, you know what I mean, for spawning me throughout my career, you know, and hopefully by next year there'll be a lot of fans in, and hopefully, they come to support me.
Last fan, more or less his last bargain didn't spar Thomas Patrick Ward, who's also on the show, who's number one with the WBO at sort of bantam. An exceptional talent, so
you go wherever the sparring is, to be honest.
No, I mean, we've been to London, we've been to Liverpool, we've been to Manchester.
Well, where the sparring is, we'll go, you know what I mean? You know, that's what it's about.
I think this has stepped up the levels. And you've had to go a wee bit of distance to try and find a better quality sparring. So.
But to be honest, we finished the camp anyway, we finished sparring anyway, so you know, we only had about 2 weeks to go. We had, you know what I mean, have we done about, can, about 100
or... All I had to do was just keep running, keep the weight down over the summer, over the lockdown.
The next 2 weeks, basically, then that would have been me.
The biggest thing for any fighters is the diet. There's not so much training, because you've built up that training over the years. It's putting all that weight on and then trying to get it back off at the end is a difficult thing. So the main thing, that kept the weight down and he's ready to go, you know, so that's the important thing. Because that's like, all the television shows are looking for guys that are ready to go. They're no, kind of give you, you know, a couple of weeks here and there. They need the shows to fill need fighters, and he's ready, so that's the most important thing at least. He's one of the few fighters that will go out this year. If you're fighting in the club shows where there's no television, I'd be surprised if you go out this year. You'd be lucky if you go out, you know, before next summer, I imagine. The way things are going, obviously the news keeps changing all the time, so I think small hall shows are a long way off, so we're happy for him to get, you know, it's good. Main thing is he always trains hard. And then once the gym's opened again, he had the facility again and start doing the weights. He's a full-time trainer anyway. And then he's been out, he's been doing his run anyway, and we've got somebody on board who's taking him out running, so everything's perfect, went perfect.
Just going about my strength work, my strength conditioner, Lewis, you know what I mean, and I usually do it twice a week, Tuesday and Thursday, so it's the first thing I do in the morning with him, you know, and just mix it up, you know. And he does my diet as well, so, you know, it helps a lot, you know. Did the picture of me there, huh?
Leg workout complete in here. Now we're going to start working on his shoulders. Maybe 2 years now, Cash, since
2 years and a bit,
2 years
and a couple of months now. I mean,
I think 2018. It was Ian Wilson at St Andrews Boxing Club that introduced Cash, and since then we went on to work with a few boxers. So I'm working Cash's diet through the year in between fights. 8 weeks before the fight, the last week before the fight, the day before the fight, so we schedule everything out. So, our idea is to make that weight without throwing too much water, and then trying to bring that weight up the last day after the weigh-in. It's going to be a bit different this fight, because he's going to be isolating for 4 days, so it's a wee bit uncharted at the moment how we're going to work that one out, but we'll get there.
I started my strength trainer maybe about five or 6 weeks ago, and it's like I've never left. Yeah, everything's been going well. This is probably the last hard week I've got to go, then I'm fine in a week and a half time.
Are you feeling strong?
Yeah, I'm feeling good. You know, my weight's good, and so I'm still eating well and drinking well, so, you know, I'm ready to go, you know. It'll be 11 months, you know, maybe by the time I box, so, yeah, I'm looking forward to boxing.
It's been hard in lockdown, because I've hardly seen him, so we lost touch for pretty much, although we're on the phone for 5 months with the lockdown. So, but since we've come back, that's us back open the gym now. 4 weeks strength training, although Cash has been training himself. It's muscle memory, just clicked back in again, and he's back as good as he was before lockdown. Again, is it every fight that we do, we like to get him improve on his strength and the conditioning side, trying to bring that up. So I think this from now, and then hopefully the next fight come in, you'll see an improvement then coming in again. But the main thing with Cash is to try to get his power and his muscle weight up, but his body fat as low as we can, so his power to weight ratio is really good. I think that's showing up in his fights now, because you get that bit more power now.